Okay guys, how are you? I first welcome you to the channel, which is about industrial projects, and we are dealing the management sort of a thing, industrial project management, with the help of the project and the research work undertaken by the research associates and the different at different levels, and just completing the given project for their study and beyond. For just following the track, we are completing the abstracts from the book of abstracts that were actually completed or compiled through first symposium, doctoral student symposium conducted at IIT Kanpur 2014, and this is the fourth abstract, which is about numerical investigation of clap and fling motion using immersed boundary lattice Boltzmann method. Pradeep Kumar S and Ashok D and Deepupam Das, Department of Aerospace Engineering, IIT Kanpur, 208016, India. Extended abstract I'm reading out for your cause. If it's interested, you can actually comment, else you can obviously go through in a go so that you can see what has already been actually transcripted or can be actually available through online resources. You can just go through and have the essence of what has been actually researched on, worked on by different associates and professors working with the team as a group. So clap and fling, a high lift producing mechanism in insect flight, is simulated using an immersed boundary lattice Boltzmann method. Effects of advanced ratio and frequency on flow field of difference Rayleigh's number have been studied. The numerical results agree well with the existing experimental and numerical data. Introduction. This paper aims of simulating the clap and fling motion first proposed by Westphal in 1973 using immersed boundary lattice Boltzmann method, LBM. Has emerged as a powerful numerical technique since past decade for simulating fluid flows. In this simulation, LBM with single relaxation BGK model is used to solve Boltzmann transport equation for particle distribution function, from which the microscopic properties of the fluid can be recovered by evaluating the moments of the distribution function. The fact that both IBM and LBM are applied, which are the immersed latest Boltzmann method and immersed Boltzmann method, both applied around the Cartesian mesh, makes this combination both attractive and possible. Formulation: in the current simulation, two rigid elliptic airfoils are made to clap and fling using an implicit velocity correction method introduced by Wu Shu to stimulate a D2Q9 Boltzmann model with 4-6 scheme and introduced by Deco L. L is used. This is how you're going to represent this D2Q2 Boltzmann method and or model with the help of this equation which is in front of you, keeping in track the forces and also the distance covered with time, and you can also have the velocity as well in terms of density. So the physical velocity at a fluid node is assumed to be sum of intermediate velocity, which is this x is equal to x star plus lambda star, where s star is this one. The unlike conventional IBM methods like direct forcing or momentum exchange method, the force density here is considered as unknown and is determined in such a way that the boundary, which is Lagrangian velocities obtained from interpolated corrected velocity field Eulerian, satisfy the no slip condition. A direct delta function interpolation is implemented as proposed by Beskin, which is in front of you, this one. This boundary velocities are used, these are the velocities normally, these are used to calculate the velocity correction at the Eulerian points using a spreading function, which then will be introduced in Boltzmann equation, which will make the field aware of the boundary through the force term. Absolutely right. So the Boltzmann equation, the Boltzmann model, the Eulerian points, and the boundary Cartesian mesh, and also you can say the correction method using the implicit velocity correction method, and you can use it the fork clip and fling as well. So these are normally the immersed IBM, and also it is LBM methods normally used. So these are all some of important techniques with mathematical expressions using to calculate. So result, the code is validated with the benchmark problems like flow over a square and circular cylinder. The figure one shows vortosity contours of four time instances in one complete clap and fling cycle. The fig two shows the corresponding time history of lift and drag coefficients. This is how I'm going to explain. These are the lift and drag coefficients, figure two, and figure one is in front of you. So the result would be, the conclusion would be, the implicit IBLBM method is able to capture the flow physics like wake capture, dynamic stall, wing-wing interaction, LEV, which makes this a robust method to investigate insects flight phenomenon. This work in future can be extended by introducing flexibility into the wing structure. That is absolutely right. So this is how this work, which has been done for numerical investigation of clap and fling motion using immersed boundary lattice Boltzmann method, which is IBM, and also it is LBM, which is the lattice Boltzmann method. You can use it for the numerical investigation, which we have done normally with the help of the velocities, physical velocities, with the help of density, with the help of the force and the displacement and time covered, and we have also covered the velocities at different, with the boundary velocities as well by different equations. So this is normally done. You can have the explanation of the different type of the velocities, different type of forces, with the different type of equations, normally covering the Boltzmann model and the lattice Boltzmann method, and which may actually use what? Use the combination of both LBM and also IBM, and it can be done with the help of the different experimental and numerical data. Normally this data is normally, when you talk about this research work, this research work is normally conducted in the laboratories, and what we are extracting from this research work, obviously the data and the numerical data is already being researched and is being well worked on by different group members, but the purpose is to go through what has been done normally at an industrial level. But these researchers are well prepared to work in any industry. Normally this is a part of their research, and we are using their research work as our primary source of not just first of all comprehending the concepts, but also using it for the actual industrial purpose when it is used in real time, in whichever industry you are working. The purpose is to use as much resource material as possible to complete or cover as much as basic concepts, from basic to intermediate, and from intermediate to advanced and more advanced concept, or highly complex or highly complex advanced concepts, which may help us to complete some of the real-time problems and situations. So these data or this information, which normally being conducted, or the results or the experimentation is normally being conducted in international conditions and standards. That is why this is the best possible resource to actually grab the concepts, not only at the international standards, but also to cover the concepts which are normally being taught at various, from the beginners to graduate, you can say, from graduate to top to postgraduate, and for postgraduate to doctorate and postdoctorate levels. So how these the different concepts are interlinked to the research work conducted by these scholars, So you can easily grab all the concepts which have already been taught from the beginner level, so even from the pre-beginners level as well. So this is how these all concepts are interconnected. Nothing is aloof, everything is connected when you talk about different levels of work or different, even a different level of study. So this approach will also apply in our practical and physical world as well. So we're going to actually use different research material, different research work, primarily from IIT, and especially given the reason to IIT Kanpur that we are actually using their resource as a prime resource of conducting our research and obviously completing our own concepts as far as aerospace engineering aerodynamics is concerned. We're able to actually, because this platform is helping us to complete as much tasks, as much concepts as possible. So with our next video, I hope that you're going to join or keep watching, or if not, please share if at any time, moment of time, you're going to watch it. And I hope that we're going to reciprocate with the same concept that you're going to portray on the comment section, so that we can see, obviously we can work in a collective manner. So with these remarks, I'm going to end up or conclude my video. Till the next video, obviously for this industrial project management or at research level or at PhD and post-PhD level, we are actually working with different papers and different research materials. So for another video, till then, take care and have a nice day.